Hi there. Mr. Pollard here, and welcome to the Mr. Pollard English YouTube channel. Thanks for tuning in. So I'm going to cover regular and irregular spellings and rules to help you improve your spelling accuracy. And hopefully by the end of the video, you'll be much more confident in your spelling of both regular and irregular words. Okay, well, the most common way when to pluralize a word is to add an S on the end. So in the examples here, cat would become cats, coat, coats, table, tables. So can you have a look at this table here? Maybe pause the video and have a look. What rule is there then for when we need to add ES? Okay, well, we add ES when the word that you're trying to pluralize ends with an S, a double S, an SH, a Z, a CH, or an X. And this is because these sounds somewhat clash with an S. So it was introduced centuries ago and exists today. So these are ones that you will need to watch out for and remember when you are pluralizing. Next one is IES suffix. Can you figure out the rule for adding IES to a word when we pluralize it? Okay. Well, if you've paused the video, here is the answer. You can see, and I'm sure you've worked this out, that words ending with Y, as all those do in the singular, we add IES on the end when we pluralize them. That's an important, quite common rule and relatively easy to learn. However, there are some Y words that where we add S in the plural as opposed to IES. So words ending in a vowel, A, E, I, O, U, plus a Y, we pluralize by just adding the S. So AY words there, trays, bays. EY words like donkey, monkey, trolley, valley, we just add an S too. And OY words, boy, toy, again, we just add an S too. So if it's a vowel plus a Y at the end, then you just add an S. What about where we add VES when we're pluralizing? Can you figure out the rule here from the list of words? Just take a moment to pause and ask yourself what those words in the singular form have in common. Well, when a word ends in an F or FE, we change the F to a V and we add ES or S to make it plural. So loaf becomes loaves, wife, wives, wolf, wolves, scarf, scarves, etc. So another rule that you can learn to help you improve your English spelling. And words ending F, there are exceptions to the VES rule. There are a few words that end in O. And these are the rules as far as I can see them. So there are some words that end in O that we add ES to. So tomatoes, potatoes, dominoes, embargoes, heroes, mangoes, echoes, vetoes, torpedoes. There are some where we have an option. We can either add an S or an ES, up to you and the mood you might be in. As in motto or mottos. Banjos, buffaloes, cargoes, halos, tornadoes, volcanoes. And there's some very obviously that we need to just add an S to. So bistros, demos, kilos, photos, memos. Often words of Italian origin, as in cellos, quartos, solos, pianos, concertos. There's a lot of music terminology. It's just an S at the end. And then we've got a few Greek and Latin words. These are words that you're not going to come across all that commonly, which is why I've left them towards the end of the video. Nucleus becomes nuclei, cactus, cacti, octopus, octopi, focus, foci, and hippopotamus, hippopotami. There's something very nice about being able to say that beautiful word. Irregular nouns then ending in IS will become ES. So axis becomes axes, analysis, analyses, crisis, crises, thesis, theses. EX and IX become CES and XES. So index, indices, appendix, appendices, vortex, vortices. and irregular nouns that change a lot. So some nouns don't follow any of the rules that we've covered so far, and we call these irregular nouns. And get your head around this. There are some irregular nouns that are singular and plural, that there's no difference whether you're referring to one or many. So that is a deep dive then into some of the spelling rules and some of the exceptions to these spelling rules. Hopefully that's helpful for you, and you can take this away and apply it and use it and practice it in exercises in your own writing. Check out my other videos in the Microvideo grammar series. Look forward to seeing you next time. All the best. Bye-bye.